Hello everybody, my name is Impiri and welcome to Call of Cthulu, the next in the Let's Play, because Bully is dead. So Jimmy's now all grown up and he's moved to the sea where he's going to fight Cthulu. Let's go. Enter madness. Right, I've got just my brightness so that the darkest icon barely visible. Yep, that looks good. Right, enter madness, new game. Yes, empty slot. Chapter 1, Pierce Investigations Agency in Boston. Edward Pierce, veteran of the First World War, drowns his memories in liquor and sleeping pills. He is now a private detective who has trouble finding a case able to lift him from his torpor. Okay. Pierce must find a new case quickly or risk losing his license. Would I lose my license for drinking? Because I think I would lose that regardless. Is it I have to meet a quota? Why can't I just take easy cases? Things I'll never know because I'm not an investigator. Enter the madness. That sounds fun. If I am mad, it is mercy. May the gods pity the man who in his callousness can remain sane to the hideous end. Ugh. Ah, do you know, I thought I was going to be in like some kind of whale carcassy thing. But I've washed up in the sea. And I have tinnitus. Stop falling in the organs. Oh, good. I've saved at this point. This is what I want to remember. I'm in. Now, what was all of that behind me? Did I swim? Yeah, move, yep. I think it's a little bit more intuitive with keyboard and mouse. Let's find out. Well, hey, it's spinning. Lots of buckets. Ah, fish skeleton. Lots of sharks. There's this weird bit, which is that I go to stop, and then I move a little step further. Headbutt. Oh, nope, nope. Can't headbutt the shark heads. What's on here? Some pliers. Down here. Hang on a second. I'm going back to the controller because with the mouse, it's super fast. And it's almost making me just a tad dizzy. Right, I could crouch through here, but I could also try this chain. That chain's working all right. Is there a lock on it? There is a lock on it. Okay. Through the crouchy hole. I like that the fog is consistent. It appears and then it disappears when I get near a rock. Candles have all melted into one. Let's try this chain. This chain also works. It's very secure. Can I run yet? LT is to run. What about punch? Nope. You must light up some item in order to interact with them. Well, there's a candle over here. Crouching, okay. LB, look. Ooh. I get some good leans. Alright, well, there's a lamp here. When an object moves up, press A. Ah. Is this... Red boxes to me say TNT. I took bolt cutter. Now my life is complete. Thought I heard something. Probably not. I cut that with one hand. I am incredible.
In my wake, hold along. Fate inescapably draws you on.
Thank you, Satan, I think. Can I cut this chain? Why can't I cut this chain? Is it because I have a way through? Any cool stuff on the sides? I came from that way. What about you? Can I add more fire? I cannot. Ooh, a jump. Nope, I can't jump up those rocks. Oh, I can't jump. Okay. Wait, this is where I was in the prologue.
What a putrid offering.
I know, right? Look at all of this stuff. What is that? A whole whale? Giant tongue? Some sharks? What else? Oh, you got a lot of whales. A hungry boy. Guess we're going this way.
You have been chosen.
I like... Whenever the game tells me I need to be running, I expect something's going to come at me. Or maybe it's just because this area is tedious. Now don't chase me, Cthulhu. We good buddies, right? There are so many candles here. I love it and also hate it. I love the aesthetic and I also just hate these candles. Why don't they smell nice? Anyway. Through into heaven. Ah.
Everything has already been written.
The monsters from I Am Legend.
But perhaps you will attempt to change your destiny.
Oh wow, you're cool. Why did you shoot up? Why did a policeman hesitate? Oh, was I there? What a very interactive nightmare.
I hate whiskey.
See, if this were me, I would have gotten to that first stage and gone, nope, and woke myself right up. Alright, consult something. I'm playing with my stuff. That's a damn good draw. No squeak or anything.
I used to be an avid reader.
Used to be an avid reader. And then what?
I used to be an avid reader.
Cool. I feel like you still are. There's just some stuff all over the place. I never understood having a sofa in the office. This is like some kind of therapist. And then why sleep on it? This makes me want to have a sofa in my office now. What about my diploma?
The agency doesn't attract top-notch cases.
Oh. United States Detective Agency of Boston, Mass. Massachusetts. Wentworth's United States Detective Agency. What's my name? Is that David? No. Something Thompson. Pierce? It's certainly something. It's October 1924. That explains the high jazz. Another cabinet.
Married woman runs off with her girlfriend. The husband couldn't understand it.
The husband never understood that his wife had left him. He kept on calling me weeks after the investigation had been closed. Oh, a closed case. You have got, like, non-squeaky file cabinets, and I love it. I can't leave my office just yet. I have to play with more stuff.
A good old story of blackmail in a speakeasy.
Uh-huh. The bar owner who hired me didn't like the way I closed his case. But when you're already outside the law, there's not a lot one can do against a private detective who's got proof against you. Oh. Okay. Red Sox beat. They beat something. Hey, more whiskey. A little bit of hair of the dog. Uh-huh. I assume this is a map of Boston. Boston Strangler escapes from state mental ward. Lots to see here at Saturday's 4-H day.
Natural sciences, linguistics, archaeology.
He used to be an avid reader.
I should get rid of all this stuff.
What is all this stuff? Prohibition. This is all the prohibition stuff. A man crashing his truck. Lots of barrels of whiskey. A lot of people and some children. I assume they're going to be digging in a mine, maybe. Class photo. More maps of Boston. You'd think you'd know Boston by now. A radio. Oh, shit, no, bring that back. Ah, fuck, I broke the radio. Was that how I saved the game? One moment.
It's been a while since I jotted down something other than my nightmares.
You jot down your nightmares? Right. Fucking hell. Let's just take a sip before I try that again. Yummy heat. The doctor can well repeat to me that I no longer need my remedy to keep my memories at bay. But I know that if I stop, the memories will return. One of these mornings, I probably won't wake up. Despite the treatment, I again hear voices in my dreams. But they are different, unknown. They seem to surface from unfathomable and ancient depths. What nameless creature is calling me? That's the case. This is me. Damn, I look good. I have no CP. Okay. I've been too much on, you know, like the censored YouTube to think that character points good. That's what that is. Mental trauma? Oh boy. Edward Pierce is a veteran of the First World War, where he took part in the Meuse-Argonne Offensive. He is one of the few survivors of the Lost Battalion, American units that suffered heavy losses from enemy and allied artillery fire. Forced to hold their position for several days, surrounded by the bodies of their fallen comrades, without food or medical supplies. The soldiers were considered as lost by their fellow countrymen. Pierce is traumatized by these events. He consumes sleeping pills and liquor to ward off the nightmares that haunt him. But he had whiskey, and he still got a nightmare, so he needs to try something better. So, okay, so this is my sanity, and I have mental trauma, which is good to know. Darkwater, I have not met anyone. Places, this is my agency. The occult. I know nothing about the occult yet. Clues, no clues. And in my inventory, oh, hell yeah. Oh, it's a lighter. My old lighter that I engraved in the memory of the 77th Infantry Division of the Main and Lost Battalion. Lost Battalion. 10778. The phone is still ringing, but I have more stuff to play with. I think. Wait. A blue drink?
I wonder why I still take these things.
The doctors described them when I returned from the war. They swore that they would put the end of the nightmares, but for a while now, their effects have been wearing off. Sure, have a drink. This will affect my destiny. Whoops! It's one boozy drink. US is voted dry. Okay, so it's the start of Prohibition. I heard a car bibbing, but I cannot see the outside world. I like your desk. Alright, let's answer the phone. He's been there for a while. Ahoy, hoy.
Are you Edward Pierce? Private investigator contracted by the Wentworth Detective Agency?
You're my secretary, aren't you not?
Hello, Mr. Pierce. I'm Lucy Sherifield, in charge of investigators over at Wentworth. I'm calling because of a problem with your file. A fire has destroyed some of our documents.
She's so Boston, I love it. I gotta get your information again. Ah, oh, look at all those character points I got. Spot hidden. Represents my ability to find hidden objects. Improving skill increase your chance of finding hidden objects. And undiscovered objects will not appear in game. Okay. Oh, I've just seen how much it costs. Well, what I want? Maybe my eloquence. What would be good? Occultism? Knowledge of the occult sciences. Oh, or picking locks. Okay. Strength. Not so much, I'm thinking, because I feel like I'm going to be using a lot of firearms. I might be wrong. I don't really know what I'm doing in this bit, but I think this is going to be more investigation and maybe hiding stuff. Medicine. I drink whiskey and sleeping pills, so I don't think I'm too fussed about that. That seems cool, though. Right, hang on. Six. Oh, if I do both of these, this is four, though. I'll wait on the occultism. I think for right now, I would probably best in maybe... Or maybe... No, I can't. All right, so I could do spot hidden and investigation, or I could do eloquence psychology. Psychology rests into your knowledge of human behavior. Improving this skill increases your chance of understanding motivations of a person based on his or her behavior or on analysis of objects. Okay. Represents my ability to influence those who you talk to by power of speech. So, do I want better speech, better hiding spots, better at analyzing crime scenes? That's already pretty high. Or better at understanding motives? Maybe eloquence and motives. Let's do that. Let's do eloquence and motives. What? It's still on two. Oh. Wait a minute. So, okay, so it's just points to that. So I could put stuff towards it then. How about I do this then? I want the spot hidden. So I'll put the rest into psychology. I can remove stuff. No, I can't. I can only remove stuff I've done. Right, validate you. Can't remove any of my little medicine. Do you want to validate his character points out to you? Sure, why not? What's the worst that can come out and tear my face off? You haven't sent me any chowder. Progress of our contractors.
You've been accepting fewer new cases.
Work is scarce.
Mr. Pierce, you know as well as I do, there's never been more investigative work than now.
He sounds a bit like...
cases worth it?
He sounds like the guy from Vampire.
Your license. Show yourself worthy of the Wentworth Detective Agency, and we might keep you on the payroll.
Oh, and might. Hmm. She said that before I even hung up the phone.
I'm coming.
Excuse me, Shadow Man. Come on in.
Sir, I came here on the advice of a person whom I hold in high esteem.
That's a fantastic painting and I want it.
I expected anything but a drunkard's lair.
Hey, I only had one sip. Would you have said that if I hadn't have had my sip?
You're free to leave anytime, sir.
Do you know to whom you speak?
Stephen Webster, industrialist and art collector. All of Boston knows you.
Tell me, Mr. Pierce, mm-hmm. Are you capable of handling a new case, or are you simply a deadbeat inebriate?
If you come to me, it means you're desperate.
Everyone's been mean to me so far.
They take me for an old fool.
I'm still having PTSD.
Sarah,
come on now.
Girl, she is dead. Even you must know of her. She was Sarah Hawkins.
Hawkins?
The painter.
Oh.
Yes. Everyone knows her work.
Everyone now.
The police accused her of killing her family. Uh-huh. They all died in a fire. Sarah,
so
her husband, and Simon, my grandson.
I can't do anything for a woman who is already dead.
You could find out
the truth.
Yeah.
They say she was mad, but I know that's a lie. She would never.
I don't know why I'm just looking
thing.
Off to the side.
But if you have no proof.
Mm-hmm. What if you didn't have proof, though?
Look. I want you to look carefully at this painting. Tell me all the assumptions that come to mind.
First off, that painting is fucking sick, and I want it. Even if it drives me mad. Oh! There's people in it.
Tell me if this is the work of madness.
I think that's a work of someone with radness.
You managed to detect some logic,
yeah, I can't see myself.
A rationality to follow so that I may understand it.
Is that all you want from me?
Yes, please.
All right. I'll look at your picture.
I'm looking into the
that's
picture. I'm looking
got.
Into the sick picture.
The painting?
I placed a file on your desk. It contains everything I have on the affair.
Okay. Wait, I have to consult my diary, first of all. That's my pause menu. This is my diary? Alright. Okay, I can't navigate to... yes, to open it, press that. Okay. I guess the dashes are the same? Right. The doctor can... Well, no, hang on. I think I've done that one. Dreams. A strange picture painted by Sarah Hawkins a short while before her tragic death was sent to her father just after the artist died. He is convinced that she is the sender. He brought me the painting so I could examine it. Stephen Webster, the wealthy industrialist, came to my office. He wants me to reopen the Sarah Hawkins case named after his daughter, who died in a fire alongside her entire family. I must examine the documents he compiled in order to know more about the case. Do I go artsy and examine the painting first, or do I read the logical parts of the investigation? Character me would read this. Me would read this. Real me would go, this one.
A warehouse on Darkwater. Some sketches of the Hawkins family.
There's some damn good sketches.
Rather thin.
Okay. A shipping label. Some of it's unreadable, but I can make out part of the address. Warehouse 36, Darkwater. The police report. It says that the fire started in the dining room and claimed the whole family. The police decided on a domestic accident, but day, nevertheless insisted on Sarah Hawkins' mental fertility. But why? Stop bibbing, Carl. A press cutting. An article written by about the marriage of Sarah and Charles Hawkins, a businessman from the island of Darkwater. They live a recluse life. They're with their only son, Simon. Okay. Ah! Oh, I didn't think you'd still be here. He'll still... take a seat, I guess. I'm going to have a stare at the painting now. Investigation.
What's this symbol on the man's chest?
Oh, you saw
it's
that.
It's as if Sarah Hawkins breathed a message into it.
So, Mr. Pierce, what do you make of these elements?
Your daughter is a fantastic painter. Oh, you shouldn't take this painting lightly. Unlock answer. Something's not right with this story. Let's find out about warehouse.
The sender's label mentions warehouse 36.
That's right. It came with Sarah's last painting.
And you think your daughter could have been the sender?
That is what you must find out. Go to Darkwater. Find warehouse 36.
Right. Okay, let's go straight to the painting.
The
unlock the answer.
Could be exactly as it appears. I think your daughter is sending you a message.
That's what I believe, too.
Mm-hmm.
It was 3 months ago that I received the call from the police telling me of my daughter's death. And yet a short while after, this painting was delivered to my home.
Amazon.
It's linked to this case, can't you
or
see?
Or whoever sends it this time.
You must find the meaning behind
horse
all this.
Horse and cart. Man going... I read about her mental fragility.
You must tell me if what the police suggest about the mental state of your daughter is true.
No. Sarah had visions. Everyone knew that.
Visions?
She never heard a fly. She only thought she saw things.
Saw things? What do you mean by that?
I never knew what she meant by that. My daughter was an enigmatic figure, Mr. Pierce. You must find out the truth about her life. And death.
No, I need more information. Where does she live?
Never heard of the place. Where is that?
It's a small, remote island off the coast of Boston.
Cool.
Sarah lived there with her son and her husband.
I suppose you want to ship me off there.
Darkwater holds the secret regarding my daughter, Mr. Pierce. You must uncover it.
Something we haven't discussed. How much are you giving me? Money-wise.
Her husband was a big deal on the island. But the police are sticking to the accident theory. Though they mentioned Sarah's mental state was fragile. I believe you are right, sir. This case is not as simple as it appears.
I am aware of that. I believe there is more to this case than just an accident.
Oh, man. I think that's everything I need to know, because I've just found out about Warehouse 36, unless it's the same.
The sender's label mentioned...
That's right.
Oh,
and
yeah, no,
that is
done
go
that.
To...
Cool. That's all the information I need
to understand.
I'm willing to do anything for my daughter to recover her honor.
Quiet down. I'm on your side.
Why'd he tell us quiet now? He's like, I'll do anything. He's like, all right, write about her.
An artist dies with her family in a house fire. Your only clue is a sort of promontory painting sent from Darkwater right before
her. Wow, that's a big word you used.
Correct.
Painting.
And the rumors about her supposed folly.
Which you don't totally deny.
Find that warehouse. Find out the truth regarding Sarah Hawkins' death. You'll be handsomely compensated.
Oh, finally, all discussion right. Of money.
I'll take the case. I'll go to Darkwater and look into the death of your daughter.
Thank you, Mr. Pierce. I didn't expect any less coming from a man in your situation.
What?
Something's queer. But it's not like I have a choice.
Okay. That man seemed queer to you.
Darkwater. I think I've got a book on the North Atlantic.
Cool.
I'll no doubt find some information on this island in there.
Oh, a book. Okay, right. I've done that. Leave for Darkwater and find out about more about Darkwater. All that remains is to leave for Darkwater. I'll certainly find something on Darkwater in my bookcase. My avid bookcase, which I think is this book, conveniently. No, that's medicine. A dense work aimed at interns and young practitioners. This first volume lists all illnesses known to the civilized world. It details the symptoms and the suitable treatments. Hey, my medicine went up.
I used to be an avid reader.
You did used to be an avid reader. Where's that Where's that book you're talking about, then? Is it in this cabinet? No. This book.
Natural sciences, linguistics, archaeology.
Oh, there's my book.
Darkwater is off the coast of Boston. But I've never heard of it. According to this book, it was often mentioned during whale hunting times at the end of the 19th century. But it seems to have been shunned since then.
I thought you were going to keep reading. Okay. Darkwater Island has been inhabited since the 14th century and is still rich with the many memories left by its lost tribes. But don't let the romanticism of these moving evidences of such naive and primitive beliefs fool you into forgetting how violent their gods are. A gigantic creature still ornates the walls of long-abandoned caves. Was it a sea or a dreamed god? No one knows, but today's inhabitants, the sons and daughters of the proud whale hunters, still remember the mysterious and tumultuous story of their small island off the coast of Massachusetts.
All I have to do is go to the port. I just hope that I can find a boat able to take me to Darkwater.
Let's hope we can find a boat to get to Darkwater. But first, I'm going to end this episode here. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more of Call of Cthulhu, please do let me know below, although I am going to do it anyway. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.